Many middle school students, high school students, and teachers alike ask the question, how do I start a Magic the Gathering club at my school? Well then look no further than Magic Kids, a nonprofit organization that will send you all the materials you need to start a club along with basic guidance and how to launch it and keep it running anywhere in the United States and all for free. It's as simple as going to magickids.org and applying for one of their kits. Why, though, is starting a magic club in your school a good idea? Well, I can think of a few reasons. First, games are an excellent way to stimulate the mind, asking players to think creatively and solve problems in ways they never have before. Being able to adapt to changing situations and difficulties is a skill we all should cultivate. Magic the Gathering is a competitive game, and a little competition is not just fun, but a great way to learn important social and personal skills that will pay dividends both inside the classroom and out. Learning how to be respectful in competitive situations, winning and losing with grace, and learning from mistakes and talking constructive criticism helps us all achieve the things we want for ourselves. Magic the Gathering provides all of this, and above all else, it's a fun way to make friends and spend one's time. Perhaps most important is that, similar to Lego Robotics and Chess Club combined, students discover the individual game pieces. Group leaders guide students to sort cards by color and type, then students build their own decks to keep, using both their knowledge and preferences, rather than passively borrowing a generic deck. Then they play, most often in a multiplayer guided setting, sometimes with reduced library sizes and life totals to keep it moving. Finally, players can help others, not just in-game, but with positive approaches to the game. Hey, how about we take a look inside one of those kits and give you an idea of what you'll receive when you apply for one? So this is the Magic Kids kit that will be sent to a teacher starting a Magic the Gathering club. There is a lot of stuff in here, and I want to remind you that this is 100% free, including shipping. But let's take a look at some of the things that are provided to teachers from Magic Kids for free so that they can get their students learning and playing the game. Thanks to sponsors such as Legion Supplies, there are deck boxes and sleeves. I love these actually. The Legion Double Mat Sleeves, an old favorite of mine. And within these boxes, we've also got the Life Keeper counters that will be enough for each student in the club, as well as some supplemental materials such as dice. And finally, just a rather large collection of those Learn to Play inserts, tokens, spin downs, just dividers that can go in the deck boxes, and other neat materials. I think these are things that experienced players will often throw to the side, but for a junior high school student learning the game, getting these little inserts about mini games that they could play, or just some cool tokens are a lot of fun. But of course, real fun is in the Magic Kids Reward Pack to be distributed by the instructor. And this has a neat collection of rares, promos, foils. And while again, a lot of this is what an experienced player would probably call jank, I think it's really important to remember that these are spells and cards that, while they don't see competitive play, although that one does, and that one, they're still magic cards. They're still a lot of fun. In fact, I've had a lot of games where when we're playing with these low price rares and mythics, and you get to actually experience some of these designs that never make it into competitive decks, that you can have a really fun experience. And I think for a student new to magic, that could be really cool. Of course, there's materials included such as this to help guide the teacher through the Magic Kids suggested activities. I'll talk a little bit more about that. And oh my goodness, basically a giant collection of cards, more than I could possibly show off here, are sent so that all the students can begin building decks and getting games. And again, yes, these are commons, uncommons, many of which are not things that you're going to see on the Pro Tour, but that doesn't mean they're not good, fun cards to play in an after-school program or a Magic the Gathering club. And overall, it's a great activity, and Magic Kids makes learning magic. Putting unused cards, yeah, these are unused cards, but putting them to work for learning. And I'm just so excited to be able to inform you that you can give your students an opportunity to have fun and learn these skills for free. You can get free Magic the Gathering cards and teaching supplies from Magic Kids. There isn't even a shipping charge. What's the catch, you might ask? Well, that's actually where you come in. So let's say I'm a teacher or a librarian and I use magic occasionally in my middle school or high school math class or in an after-school program like a game club. While I'd love to give all my students sleeves, deck boxes, dice, and extra cards, let's face it, the cost of all those things adds up, and it can be a lot to ask, even on a school stipend. Thank goodness for companies like Card Kingdom, sponsor of this channel, Ultra Pro, Legion Supplies, Die Hard Dice, and others who help make these kits possible. Maybe there are teachers out there who are just vaguely familiar with the game of Magic. They like the idea of it, but they don't really have the confidence to get the ball rolling on a full-fledged club. No worries. Magic Kids has developed a semi-structured curriculum of sort, build, play, intentionally designed by a research professor and middle school teacher to help support your intellectual health of young adults. Start with 10 basics and 10 creatures, and you're off and running. This nonprofit got started about 6 years ago in the lunchroom of a major teaching hospital. If you were at any major magic events of the last several years in the Midwestern United States, you may have seen them as the official Learn to Play people at magic fests. Or maybe it was when I showed you their very own format, Oathbreaker. That's right, these are the folks behind the Planeswalker-centered variant of Commander. If you'd like to learn more about that, check out my videos here. Now, you may be saying, well, I'm not a teacher, and I'm not a student of those grade levels, so this doesn't apply to me. Nice try, but I'm not going to let you off the hook that easily. If you're not serving young adults directly, as I've explained, consider these options where you can still be of a great help. 1. Let teachers know. Help me get the word out. There are over 3.5 million teachers in the United States. Chances are you know at least one. 2. Donate money at magickids.org. Each of the dozens of kits that go out each week cost about $30 each to ship, and contributing to the payment of that cost goes a long way. 3. Just toss some playable cards and bulk rares into a priority mail flat rate box and mail it to the Magic Kids office at the address below. You know, a lot of us players have these giant collections of bulk rares that aren't worth anything, but are still magic cards that would be fun for these kids to play with. And that's something that Magic Kids can use. You can put together packages, whether they're organized by color or not, of cards that you wish to donate, and it's a great way to get rid of those unwanted cards and also help the organization out. 4. Play Oathbreaker. More eyeballs on the format means more attention for the Educational Services charity. Plus, getting some games in is fun. Now, there's a lot of really great talented people behind Magic Kids, but I wanted to give special credit here to Magic Kids educational lead, Mr. Kelly Schrant of Schrant Intellectual Health. He's the one with volunteers that actually implemented this in our region. He's a grant and award-winning literal NASA Honeywell Space Camp goer, Lego robotics guru, and all-around nice guy. Many Magic the Gathering players ask the question, how can I give back to the game that has given me so much? The answer is short and sweet. MagicKids.org, your one-stop nonprofit to give back and get involved on your terms. If you're a teacher with an established group of young adults in mind, please apply for a kit. And if you are not, please help in the other ways I've mentioned. Giving cards, donating money, or even just taking some time to play Oathbreaker. It's even on the Wizards of the Coast spell table now. And if you are ordering a kit, please, please, please be patient. These are being done by hand, and they're going out in a growing volume during a time where our mail delivery systems are ever impacted by the pandemic we're all emerging from. So again, patience, calm, we'll get there. And I hope very much this video has been of some help to you in the way that I truly believe Magic the Gathering can be of some help to young, developing students. As a father myself, I know that there's a lot worse things my son could spend his time doing than sitting down and playing Magic the Gathering. Building decks, thinking creatively, engaging in mathematics, and best of all, socializing with other people in person. You know, I feel that Magic the Gathering clubs should be as commonplace at junior high and high schools as chess clubs are or robotics clubs are. I feel they really are on that same level of value to the students. And so if you do know someone in that age range, even if you're not a teacher, just let them know about this video. If you do know teachers at that school, let them know about Magic Kids and what they're offering. Thank you to everyone watching, and of course, to Magic Kids for this amazing endeavor.